One day I remember, because at that time, Akhi, my wife, as I mentioned, she was very, very devoted Catholic from the Philippines. So she would never miss any mass of
Sunday.
That is like, you know, so she invited me to come with her. Now, I love her. And because I love her, I had to go with her. I used to line up during the, you know, the Holy Communion thing they call, and the priest would give me that biscuit where there is a cross engraved on that piece of bread. And he would say, in the name of the Father, the Son, and Holy Spirit. And I would take it, but deep in my heart, ya akhi, I felt that there's something wrong with this. Yeah, I didn't know what to do.
So, the famous superstar commits suicide.
No.
You follow your wife's footsteps to the church.
No.
When did you give it all up?
I said I wanted to pray. One night I woke up and I said, I'm fed up with going to the church. I'm fed up with this, you know, bothering thoughts that comes after the incident. So I said I wanted to pray. So I woke up in the middle of the night one night. I performed my wudu and I started to pray. No qibla direction, nothing.
Nothing.
Just Allah. Yeah, I don't know what it was. These two rak'ah or three rak'ah, I don't even remember. And wallahi, I prayed and I cried to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I made dua, ya Allah, yani, relieve my heart from that pain and that confusion. I really cried to Allah so much. After I said, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, in this particular prayer, I got scared. You know why? Because my wife was at the back. She was actually watching me all the time. You know what my wife told me that night? She said, I wanted to try the prostration, but I don't want to become a Muslim. I just want to try the Muslims at prayer.
Right.
And then we ended up praying together next to each other. And I gave her a printed form of the salah. And when she hit the ground with her forehead and nose, I heard her crying. Wallahi, I heard her crying. She was crying. And then she said what? God is worthy of being praised and worshipped like this. This is the way we should worship. She didn't know, and I didn't know at that time, that even Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, in the Bible, prostrated to God Almighty. She didn't know, and I didn't know at that time, that even Abraham, Moses, Joshua, all these...
That's how they all prayed.
Yes. One day we were watching, we were listening to a tape about the purpose of our existence. And the Sheikh was shouting in the crowd like, are you so arrogant to acknowledge that there is only one God? Are you so arrogant or are you ignorant? Because if you're arrogant, then Allah will deal with you on the day of judgment. But if you're ignorant, then here you are. Now we are telling you to accept one God. And during this lecture, 40 people I heard have accepted Islam. And we heard them reciting the Shahada with the Shaykh. My wife was one of them.
SubhanAllah.
She was in her room and I was at a far distance. And I saw her moving her lips with the Shahada.
Right.
So I went up to her and told her, isn't it time, Yani, to acknowledge? Come on. We've been in this for 2 years, and you saw many books around, the tapes of Sheikh Ahmed did that and all. She said, I already did. I said, what? Repeat again.
Yeah.
And then she took the Shahada in front of me that day. And wallahi, since then, my wife became so thirsty to learn about Islam and so thirsty to share the knowledge that she learned about Islam. But guess what was the next surprise?
What?
5 months later, we are in the Kaaba. We are at Hajj, yeah, and that changed everything.
What a story.